Joseph and all our brethren in Christ.
Nay, for the dead Lord thou, O thou shalt remove afar from me my neighbor, my acquaintances, because of thy initiative. O Lord God, of my salvation, by hearing my prayer and by thine before thee, let my prayer come before thee, by thou my hearing to the supplication. Bless the Lord of my soul and all that is written in me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord of my soul, forget not all that he hath done for thee, who is gracious unto all thy iniquities, who healeth all thy infirmities, who redeemeth my life from corruption, crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire of good things, that you shall be renewed with the life of the peoples. The Lord perform deeds of mercy and execute judgment for all that are wrong. He hath made known his wisdom to Moses and the sons of Israel and things that he hath heard. Compassion and mercy for thee, long suffering and plenteous of mercy, that unto thee if we be angry, neither unto eternity will he be wrong. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and from the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy with our over him that feareth. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as a father hath compassion upon his sons, so hath the Lord hath compassion upon them that fear. For he knoweth where we are made, he hath remembered the fear of us. As for man, his days are as grass, as a flower of the field, so shall he blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over it, then it shall be gone, and no longer will it know the bliss thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity even unto eternity, upon them that fear him, and his righteousness upon sons, upon them that keep his testament and remember his commandments to do. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty and strength, to perform of his word, to hear the voice of his word. Bless the Lord, all ye his works, his ministry that do his will. Bless the Lord, all ye his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear unto my supplication, thy truth. Hearken unto me thy righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant, for thy sight shall no man believe be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, yet humbled my life down to the earth. He sat me in darkness as well as in the bond of the dead, and my spirit within me has become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember days of old, I meditated all at once. I pondered on creation and things. I stretched forth my hands and feet, my soul thirsted and after the body listened. You give me, O Lord, my spirit and faith in me. Do not thy face look me, lest I die, and I never die to see good. Cause me to hear thy mercy and hope, for it may be a cause me to know, O Lord, the way where I should walk, and as the end of the day of my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to be at the foot of refuge. Teach me to know what thou art. Ever the Spirit shall be the light of darkness, and thy enemies, save O Lord, shall not be. And thy righteousness shall not bring my soul out of affliction, and thy mercy shall not utterly destroy my enemies. Thou shalt have all that are faithful in the soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and to my prayer, and to my servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and to my servant. Thy Spirit shall be the light of darkness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and in the ages of ages, hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. Hallelujah, 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 glory to thee, O God. For our God and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, land, and air, for our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All these to remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Time
instructing sign, or for the disciples in the next resurrection, saying, Verily Christ hath invaded Hades, for he alone is the powerful and mighty one. He raised with him all those who were corrupt, with the power of his cross and through the fear of condemnation. Or is the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, else verily him upon the cross will lie fall, most numbered among the dead. Let us rise after 3 days, O Savior, is raised out of corruption. Lord of the heavenly power, shine to me, the of life. Glory to the passion of Christ. Glory to the resurrection. Glory to the condescension. O thou, O Lord, the Lord, the Lord. Both now and ever, and the days of the Jesus. O Mary, you revered above the Lord. Lift us who have fallen in the abyss of evil despair, trespasses, and sorrows. But let us give salvation to sin. Thou art an offering and strong intercessor.
Blessed art thou, Lord, teacher of Jews.
Glorified is thy kingdom of the nation together to be generated by the Holy Spirit and returned to the form of unity. For he is full of offense with the Father and the Word.
My soul will rejoice with those who say, let us go into the courts of the Lord. My heart is exceedingly glad. Great fear shall be in the house of David, for the seas shall be set, and all tribes in the company of the earth shall be judged. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Verily this means to offer glory, might, and power to the Holy Spirit, as to the Father and the Son, for the Trinity is one in substance, not in person.
Thank you.
inheritance. Visit thy world with mercy and compassion. Exalt the horn of Orthodox Christians and send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our all immaculate Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all laudable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all the holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Tremethos, and Nectarios of Pentapolis, the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrios the merstreamer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the God-bearer of Antioch, Charlampos and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Fotini, Marina, Paraskeva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, of St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the martyr Alexander and the virgin martyr Antonina of Constantinople, venerable Theophanes the monk, and Pansemne, the former harlot of Antioch, and John the wonder worker, metropolitan of Tobolsk and all Siberia, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Spread your hallowed and sacred minister, even
have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God. Our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Oh,
it is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and through ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, and their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed, glorious Lady, Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
And our whole life under Christ our God.
those with strength that he hath girded himself.
Cyprus and Antioch, speaking the word to none except Jews. But there were some of them, men of Cyprus and Cyrene, who on coming to Antioch spoke to the Greeks also, preaching the Lord Jesus. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number that believed turned to the Lord. News of this came to the ears of the church at Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he was glad, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast purpose, for he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith. And a large company was added to the Lord. So Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large company of people. And in Antioch, the disciples were for the first time called Christians. Now in those days, prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. And one of them, named Agabus, stood up and foretold by the Spirit that there would be a great famine over all the world. And this took place in the days of Claudius. And the disciples determined, everyone according to his ability, to send relief to the brethren who lived in Judea. And they did so, sending it to the elders by the hand of Barnabas and Saul.
Each being that readeth, and to thy spirit.
Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. And he went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every disease and every infirmity among the people.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord God Almighty. life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Selects these,
not because there's any natural advantage to having a church full of weak, foolish, sinful people, but because these are the ones who most need the church and the healing of God. The foolish, the sinful, the sick, the broken, and the ones whose transformations will most vividly demonstrate the mercy and power of God to the world. He chooses the foolish to confound the wise. How can these unlearned men know these things? Well, by the power of God. So, you might be wondering how this applies to us. At the very least, I think we should recognize a couple of things. First of all, we did not choose Jesus. You know, Jesus chose us. It was his calling that we were blessed to hear, and certainly not our own wisdom, our study, our epic spiritual journey, like wagon train across the centuries studying church history that led us to Orthodoxy. We might like to think so, but really it was God calling us. We are Orthodox Christians entirely by the grace and calling of God. Furthermore, he chose us, not necessarily because he thought we would lend a touch of class to the place, but because we were the ones who needed it. We are not Orthodox because we were better. We are Orthodox maybe because we are worse, and because we most need the healing grace of the church. We are the ones most in need of rescue and salvation. I think it's important that we basically, you know, from time to time remind ourselves of these things. It is God's calling, and he called us not because we're special, but because we needed his grace. It's good to remind ourselves so we don't forget the grace upon which we stand and must continue. We often refer to the Orthodox Church as a spiritual hospital where the many things, you know, in the life of the church offer us therapy designed to heal our souls, and this is true. And this isn't some kind of new agey thing, you know, the early fathers referred to it. As early as the early second century, you can find writings that refer to the church as a hospital. And this is really before hospitals, medical hospitals existed. That was based on the model of the church. The church, the Christian church, built the first medical hospitals, which, you know, were not so great, but certainly no worse than what we have today. But if we forget that God first loved us before we loved him, that he called us, and that he is not in the habit of calling the best and the brightest, but the lowliest. You know, if we forget this, forget that our calling is entirely of grace, and calling to be something really wonderful, not because we are, but because God can make us so, then we tend to have a bad view, I think, of the hospital. We don't see ourselves as in need of healing. We don't see ourselves in need of correction. And we find the therapies that the church offers to be drudgery. They're more like obligations. Say your prayers. Yes, I prayed last week. You know, keep the fast. Get up and come to church. You know, whatever. Yeah, write a check and drop it in the tithe box. I like to harp on that one a lot, right? Harp, I get it. That's what angels do. It's important to recognize we love because God first loved us. We're here because he called us. He has granted us a great privilege. These things are not obligations. They are our healing. It's not like the Orthodox sat around one day and said, you know, Orthodox is too easy. We need to find a way to bump it up a little bit, make it more challenging. How about if we tell people they can't have pork chops on Friday? That'll kill them. No. It's not that way at all. These things are necessary. They are essential. It is essential we're going to break the sickness of our passions and learn to deny ourselves a little bit of things here and there. Maybe a little food. Maybe a little time when we come to worship. Maybe a little of our money when you make sacrifice to God in the temple. These are all part of worship. These are all part of living the Christian life. But we almost see them as optional. I can pray if I want to. I can give to the church, whether or not, if I want to or not, you know. That's not how it works. We don't make the rules. God makes the rules. And where there is love, there is no drudgery. There is no obligation. I'm not saying that we run to our prayers with joy. But maybe we force ourselves to pray out of a sense of love for God. Did you know that forced prayers, according to fathers, have great value in the eyes of God? You don't want to pray, but you make yourself pray. You overcome your bad habit and force yourself to pray. God loves that because he knows you're really trying. That, you know, maybe your heart isn't yet filled with warmth and love, but you know at least the right thing to do and you're making yourself do it. So don't feel bad in the morning if you're saying your prayers and you basically have to drag yourself. You still have bruises on your throat, you know, forcing yourself there. It's okay. You did the right thing. It's when you blow it off because you don't want to deal with it that that's not so good. That's not so good. We want to love God. And the way to love God, remember what Jesus said, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. We need to obey in order to love. Orthodoxy has been called the religion of love because it emphasizes the love of God toward us. And it sets as its lofty goal that every one of us would gain the love and be utterly and completely transformed by it into a perfect reflection of God's love. And here we are speaking of the most sublime form of love. The kind of love that sacrifices all for the beloved and even prompts one to lay down his life for the other. This is the love of God for us, seen in the life of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has called us to follow him. This is the kind of love that we are meant to have, that God wants us to have, and that we can have if we pursue it. You know, the love of God is the reward. And God will love us. It's just always the question of what we will do with that love. Conform ourselves to it, or oppose it, make ourselves the opposite. And of course, the love of God is not fundamentally expressed by emotion, but by action. Proper actions lead toward the cultivation of love and help us to secure it. I mean, you know, many times I've made the analogy of like marriage. And in a marriage, feelings come and go. And if you live by feelings in your marriage, you won't be married for long. But action. When the feelings are absent or when the feelings are incorrect, matters not as long as we act well toward one another. And it's the same with God. You know, you don't love God today, so what? You still say your prayers. You still get up and come to church, right? Maybe you didn't feel like it. Maybe some of you forced yourself. But I won't name names, but I have to speak. Okay, my wife. She forced me to get out of bed this morning. But that happens every morning. So, kindness, gentleness, mercy, mutual respect. These are the things that characterize a good marriage and certainly characterize, you know, how we should approach God. I mean, out of gratitude for his mercy, his kindness toward us. And really, it characterizes a good family, a good marriage, and even a good parish. A good parish is a family that in which all the members care for one another and contribute to the common good, whatever level they can. That, you know, is what we're working on, right? Is to love one another as God loved us. The altar calls just in a few moments. You know, we are such individuals, and it's hard for us to think beyond ourselves or sometimes our own families, maybe. But that's the goal here. God wants us to love one another, all of us together. That's a mighty goal, isn't it? And yet, this we can do. If we pray for one another, We shouldn't gossip, right? We shouldn't do evil to one another. We shouldn't ignore one another or be indifferent. We don't deal with difficulties by just blowing a person off. And as long as you sit on that end of the coffee hour room, I'm fine, you know. But we try to reconcile. We try to love one another. We try to, well, you know, read the scriptures. Paul says crazy things like, put one another's interests above your own. Whoever does that these days. But that's how we should live, right? We need, if we can't learn to love one another, then I don't know if there's any hope for us whatsoever. We should try. We should care and support and pray for one another. Because this is a holy community. And to love one another in this day is a holy fulfillment, a holy commitment. It requires dedication from each other, purity, integrity, openness. You know, this is what Christ calls us to. I started out, if you can remember way back when I started this homily, that it was about Christ calling his disciples. And we also are called. We didn't just become disciples, we are called. He called us, and he makes the rules, and he tells us, you want to follow me, do this. You don't follow me on your terms, you follow me on my terms. And his terms are this, that you love one another as God has loved you. That we find healing for ourselves and for one another in a grace-filled, God-protected community like this, serving one another. Maybe we don't feel qualified to be called, qualified to serve, qualified to love one another in this way. I think if you feel that way, you're right. But God doesn't call to qualify, he qualifies all. You're called, that's the important thing. You are here because God called you. You no longer have the choice to decide whether or not you want to be a Christian. You simply ought to rise to that occasion and say, whatever I need to do, I will do. I mean, that's a good attitude, right? We're still going to struggle. We're still going to force ourselves to pray. We're still going to force, our wives are going to force us to get up and come to church. Is that okay? If we do that every day and we're here, that's okay. We won. It's when we give up, when we stop praying, when we stop caring, when we stop supporting, when we stop, you know, helping, then we lose. So if you've got to fight every step of the way, that's okay. Because that's the important thing, is to persevere and be faithful to the God who has called you, to the Lord, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Jesus, O God, by thy grace, praise God.
That all be started by thy mighty name, ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. now and ever and unto the ages of ages. President of the United States and all civil authorities and for our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin, Colleen, and family, for Wanda, Shelley, Linda, Drew, Leo, Otto, Scott, and Yumi, for Jared and Destiny, for Donald, for Sophia, Nadia, Angela, Destiny, that they may have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for the Deacon Mark, for the 222 Orthodox martyrs of the Boxer Rebellion, for Christina newly departed this life, that the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ.
Christ our God.
Hear the compassions of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and to ages of ages. Of which we know what and which we know not. and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou dost vouchsafe to receive at our hands. Even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged many are swarming along board on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
thank you.
John, a busy city and countryside, and those who in faith dwell therein. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who travel by sea, by land, and by air, of the sick, the suffering, captives, and their salvation. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit and do good works in thy many churches, gather and remember the poor, and upon us all send forth thy mercies. Grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise and all honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and all within and forever through ages of ages. Of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Attentive. Holy things are full. St Barnabas. Secondly, we can only serve the sacrament of communion to those who are chrismated members of the Eastern Orthodox Church. But all may join us after for the blessed bread that we serve at the very end of the service, which is for all people.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Thank you. three bishops and my pastor.
Yeah.
is now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Spirit, now and ever, and
who rose from the dead, Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of the holy, glorious, and laudable apostles, Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, and Bartholomew, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Adam, of the martyr Alexander and the virgin martyr Antonina at Constantinople, the venerable Theophanes the monk and Gethsemane the former harlot of Antioch, and John the wonder worker, metropolitan of Tobolsk, and all Siberia, whose memory we celebrate the day of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us. For as much as he is good and loveth mankind, through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.